Say nothing. Nothing is impossible with you. And beloved, this morning, nothing is impossible with our God. Hallelujah. He is moving in a new dimension. He is doing something new in our life. He is moving in great way in our life. And we are going to talk about that topic with God. The God of all possibilities. Haven't been talking about faith for the past 3 weeks. We have seen so much of faith. And we have come to know that there is a God who operates in the realm of the place where things are impossible and begin to make them possible. If he operates in the realm of the visible man, then he is not God. If he operates in the realm of what we can see, what we can value, what we can function in, then he is not God. But what makes him God is that he comes to that realm, the place of all hope lost, the place of all things that everything looks as if it's a reproach, the place where there is no way out, the place where the doors are locked, the place where the doctors have said no more hope. Have you come to that point where somebody have looked at it and said there is no hope in you? Then the doctors look at them and say, well, we have treated you, we have done our best, the best is for you to go and wait for you to die. That is why he is God. That is why he is God. He is the God of all possibilities. He comes to that realm, to the place of situation, to the place of challenges, to the place where all men have failed, to the place where your efforts have failed, where your power has failed, where your wisdom has failed, where you have tried all your best and your best isn't good enough. And he comes in there and he begins to make it possible. The God of all possibility, that place of barrenness, that place of dryness, that place of famine, that place where there is no way that you can harvest anything, he comes to make it fruitful. That is why he is God. If he comes to the place where the land is already flatter, how do we prove his power? How will he prove his words? You see, that is why I always tell you, your situation is opening door. It's making room for the glory of God. It's making room for the God of all possibilities. So come to begin to make things possible. For I heard in his word that he said, with men it is not possible. He said, but not with God. I always like that writing in man. He said, but not with God. He said, with men it is impossible. When you look at your challenge, you look at your situation, you look front, you look back, you don't see any hope in it. He said, with men it is impossible. When you look around you, everyone around you even lose hope. They can't see you coming out of that situation. They can't see you moving forward. But he said, not with God. With God it is possible. He said, with men it is impossible. With men that thing cannot work out. With men there is no hope in that thing. With men there is no solution. With men there is no coming up. With men there is no uplifting. With men there is no lifting. With men, they, you know, they look at it and say there is no lifting. With men there is no fruitfulness. But he said, that is not God. He said, not with God. Not with God. Not with God. Oh, somebody follow me to the book of Mark. We need to blow this morning. Let us go to the book of Mark and let us see where he said it. That not with God. Not with God. Not with God. With God, all things are possible. With God, all things are possible. Mark 10:27. Father, we thank you. Father, we thank you. In his time. In his time, he makes all things beautiful. In his time, Lord, please show me every day all the things I need to know as you're teaching me your way. Upon them said, with men it is impossible, but not with God. Because He is God. Because He is the maker of everything. With men, when you look at it, there is no way it is going to work out. With men, when you look at it, there is no way that your situation can change. When they look at it, they say, look, this one, leave me, I all don't finish. Praise thy Lord. They can't see hope. Why is it not with God? That challenge that you, and even you, before you, you don't see possibility. Are you not in that position sometimes when you look at yourself, you don't see any way out? Sometimes we are there. Even you yourself, you don't even have hope or faith in yourself. But the word of God says, with men it is impossible. He said, but not with God. He said, well, that's what the Bible says. He said, for with God, what happens? All things. Did he say some things? With God, what happens? All things. Everything is possible with God. Everything. Everything. There is nothing that is outside Him that is not possible. Everything. You better know today that that which you are facing is possible. That pain, there is possibility of taking it away. That reproach, there is possibility. Because our sister led us to pray and we are taking away reproach. There is possibility of taking away that reproach. You have to stop seeing with your visible eye. Begin to see with the eyes of the Word of God. Begin to see with the eyes of what God is seeing. Begin to see the realm that God is seeing. God is not seeing what you are seeing right now. God is seeing the perfect man. God is seeing the perfect woman. God is seeing international business. He's seeing breakthrough. Open. He sees finances overflowing your life. He sees you moving in every dream, in every vision you have had. And He's telling you, with men, it might be impossible. If it's impossible with men, say, but not with me. Not with me. Not with me. Have you lost hope? Have you lost hope? You have been thinking that, oh, this one is gone, and you have lost hope in yourself. Have you lost faith? And you have lost faith. And Jesus said, when the Son of Man will come, shall He find faith on earth? And you have lost faith even in yourself. You have lost faith in God. You have lost faith in prayers. You have lost faith in those things you are believing in for, and you have put them aside. And you are saying, Lord, I'm not going to ask again, because I have asked it for so many years, it's not coming. And God is saying, I should tell you, I make all things beautiful in my time, because it is perfect. I am a perfect God. With men it is impossible. I don't care how long it has been. Men look at age. I don't look at age. I do my thing at my own right now. Have you not seen me when I put myself in the life of Abraham? Did you see when I put that I don't look at age? Did you see when Sarah was born and said, I am 90. Can we have pleasure? Can't you see that I don't work by age? I am a God that does not work by age. For some of you that is thinking, even at my age, can this young happen again? Or even Sarah said so, even at my age, at our age, can we still have pleasure? But God is saying, can't you see what I did in your life? That I, by God's age, I know how to renew things. For I make all things beautiful in my own time. And your own, I'm going to make it beautiful. That which you are going through is not a challenge. It is because I want to testify. I want you to testify to my name. That is what I'm going to enjoy for my glory. So I'm going to make it beautiful. I'm going to beautify every part of your life. I shall perfect that which concerns you. Because I am a God of all possibilities. I make the way where there seems to be no way. Did you not hear? Did you not see? When the people came to a crossroads, there was no way for them to move forward. There was no way for them to move backward. Oh, when they look at their front, there was a Red Sea. When they look behind them, there was Pharaoh chasing. But the word of God came unto them. And He said, stand still and you shall see the salvation of the Lord. And what is that you are going through? And He said, shall I not see you this morning? Stand still and you shall see the glory of the Lord. For he who believes that, nothing is impossible. For him that believes that, I did not hear that word. The scripture says, shall I not to you? For nothing is impossible. For he who believes that, if you believe in my word, stand still and you shall see my salvation. For I am the God who makes all impossible to become possible. Father, we thank you. The God of all possibilities. When the enemy comes in, that is what they like to do. Say they come to steal. They come to kill. They come to steal your joy. They come to kill your faith. They come to frustrate you. They want you to make as if I am not there. But I am watching. I am watching. Because I am going to prove to the enemy that I am your God. I am going to prove to the enemy that I am still watching over you. I am going to prove to the enemy that I rule in your life. That I reign in your life. That is why he said. He said, not with God. Not with God. Not with God. Hey, you need to come to that point and say, not with God. Oh, whatever it is today, I want you to know that not with my God I will be here. But with my God, it is possible for me to move out of this level. You can move out of that level. You cannot limit it to that level. You position, take it from glory to glory, from glory to glory, from glory to glory, from glory to glory. God moves forward, for he's always in the mover, and he says, shall ask for you, it is possible for you to move forward from where you are. Stop limiting yourself to that place you are. There is a realm I'm taking you to, but not with men, but with God, not with God, but with God, all things are possible. You look at yourself. Where is the hope that I can get to this height? And maybe somebody tells you, God is going to do something marvelous in your life. Tell me, where did sign say it will happen? That is why there should be no sign. Elijah was praying. He said, we have to go and pray. And we have already prophesied there's going to be rain. We have to go and pray. And he went between his knees. He was praying as he was praying. And he said, no, go and look at. The man said, oh, there are no sign, no. You don't need to look for sign. You don't need to look for sign. The word of God is your sign. And the word of God has come today. He said, with me all things are possible. That is the sign you need. Hold on to the word of God. And Elijah said, go again. Seven times the man kept going. There was no sign. But Elijah knew that God would bring that rain. He knew he had the God of all possibilities. He knew that God is able to answer him. Because he belonged to God. Beloved, you belong to God. You identify with the Son. You are walking with the Son. You have given your life to the Son. So there is no prayer that he does not answer you. He is the God that answered that prayer. And you should know that God is able to make that rain to fall. So Elijah never gave up. He said, I know. I have a God of all possibilities. I have prophesied. And rain have to fall. And he continued to say, God of all possibilities. You are able to make rain to fall. Even in this place, when the cloud is not showing sign, you are able to make rain to fall. Oh, God of all possibilities. And the moment he was continuing to do it, he never turned back. He never gave up. Oh, we saw it last week. He said, my soul will not take pleasure in him that go back. Elijah did not go back. He continued to persevere. He go, and God said, yes, I am taking pleasure in you. I can see faith rising in you. Even when you did not see sign, but I can see faith. You don't have to see sign for you to have faith. When you look around you, there is no sign. There is no sign of having food on the table. There is no sign of having money to cook. There is no sign of having drink water to drink. There is no sign of moving forward. You look around, you can't see the sign. But God is saying, don't have to look out for the sign. For I am the one who I able to send the rain to feed you. I am the one who is able to make sure that there is food in your house. I am the one who is able to make sure that business will move forward. When you look around you in the business, there is no sign that this business will move forward. When you come and you look at it, is there any hope at all in this business? I think God has failed. And he's announcing to you today, I am a God that never failed. Have God changed? Have God failed? He said it to have for the God to do. He said, I am the God of all possibilities. And he said that business that you come every day. And you look and say, there is the hope in this business. Ah, God, this one don't pass you. Nothing is impossible with me, that's what he's saying. With me, all things are possible. I am able to order the steps of men. But the steps of men are ordered by the Lord. Did you not hear it in the word? He said, the steps of men are ordered by the Lord. Praise thy Lord.
Hallelujah.
And he will order their steps.
Yeah.
And they will come and begin to dwell. And begin to patronize you. Let us look at the scripture again. Luke 1:37. The God of all possibilities. The God of all possibilities. Luke 1. Look at where God was speaking. 37.
For no word from God shall be void of power. And Mary said, behold, the handmaid of the Lord, be it unto me according
to that. Luke 1:37. For with God nothing shall be impossible. That is 37. He said, with God nothing shall be impossible. This was when the angel came to announce to Mary. Came to tell her that something that has never happened before is about to happen with you. You. And Mary say, how can this be? I don't know, maybe you are asking God, how is it possible for this one to happen? How can it be? You have been looking at God without your small visible eye. It is time for you to look at him as God. You have been looking at him as man that you see every day. It is time for you to look at him as God. The angel came to Mary and made an unusual announcement. He came to Mary and he said, look, say Mary, you are highly favored. Number one, he told him you are highly favored. She said, yeah, am I favored? And he says, you are going to conceive. And this child is going to conceive. The Holy Spirit will come upon you and you will conceive. He said, Mary asked that question. Then Mary said unto the angel, how shall this be? How is it possible? That is what he's asking. In fact, let me finish it. He said, see, I know
not a man. How is it possible? Saying, I don't have financial proof to push this business forward. How is it possible for me to marry? Saying that no man has been looking at my side. How is it possible for me to get to this level of life I have been desiring? See, there's nobody ready to help me. Maybe you are asking those questions. Mary asked a question. According to the level of revelation I came to Isaiah, you are going to conceive and have a child. I am not married. I am a virgin. Not married. I don't know any man. And the law of God says you have to marry. But God is saying, I am the one that breaks through my laws. I am the one that changes my law. When I put God, I can decide to do it in another way as well. And he said, how is it possible? And the angel announced to Mary. He said to Mary something in 37. For with God, nothing is impossible. With God, nothing, absolutely nothing. Nothing is too difficult for thee. Nothing, absolutely nothing. Nothing is too difficult for thee. Nothing, absolutely nothing. Nothing is too difficult for thee. Mary said, how is this possible? I do not know a man. Seeing I do not have financial capital to do that business. How is it possible? Seeing I do not have a way of achieving this thing. How is it possible? Seeing I do not have that which would have made me to be well. I don't even have money to buy the medication. How is it possible for me to be well again? Mary asked a question. Just like me, you are asking, and the angel is saying, I should announce to you this one as God is telling me to announce to you. The angel said to her, with nothing is impossible with God. Stop seeing God as a God that cannot do things. Stop seeing God at the level of what you can see. Stop seeing God, limiting God to that which you are able to do. Stop seeing God as a God that is just like that man that can relate with you. See God as God. For the moment he begins to operate with man, he's in the level of man that as man can see, he sees it to be God. Praise my Lord. The moment he begins to do, in the level of man can see, he sees it to be God. He will do that unusual thing. And didn't Mary get pregnant? Of course she was pregnant. Of course she came back to a human being. Praise thy Lord. She did not deliver nothing. She did not deliver air. She came back to the Son of God. Praise thy Lord. So God is saying, as she said to you this morning, that with him all things are possible. That which you have been looking at as impossible. It's as you announced to you that there is hope in that situation. There is hope in that which you are going through. There is hope in that which you are seeing. There is hope in that which you are, that challenge you find yourself. There is hope in everything you can see. Praise thy Lord. Let's look at the case study in the book of John chapter 9. There's a case study we can look at in that place. John chapter 9, the man that was born blind. John chapter 9, the case study of all things that is possible with God. John chapter 9. God just wanted us to take this message this morning. This was not my message, but God wanted to tell somebody that I'm doing something in your life. John chapter 9. And as Jesus passed by, he saw a man which was blind from his birth. And his disciple asked him, saying, Master, who did sin, this man or his parents, that he was blind? Jesus answered, neither had this man sinned, nor his parents, but that the works of God should be made manifest in his life. I must walk the works of him that sent me while it is day, that night cometh when no man can walk. This man was born blind. He had an issue that seemed impossible. Because they said he was born, and at this time he was already above 40 years. And before Jesus came, nobody had experienced miracle of opening of a man that was born blind. They had never experienced miracle that eyes could be opened. For the one who has been with the Father came with what the Father is able to do. The one who knows that with God all things are possible. Remember, he's the one that told them in the book of Mark, he said, not with God. He said, with men it's impossible. He said, but not with God. The same one have come. And he came to this situation. And when they came to this situation, they said, Master, who did sin now? This man was born blind. And why is he born blind?